good morning, everybody, and welcome to the vlog. I hope the start of your day is amazing. We're gonna jump right into things with some Kluber clutches, if you don't mind. This girl here, oh my God, she definitely put a lot of energy into that second clutch. You can look, mama is a little beat up, that is for sure. That's about as thin as you're gonna see a snake here in our collection for sure after two clutches. So she's definitely gonna need to get some meals in her, but I'll be totally honest with you, she should beef up and she should be completely fine. I've actually seen even worse than that. I'm not concerned about her, but definitely gonna have to get some water in with her, get her some food here later today, get her back on the mend. And again, her work is done for the year, so she gets to beef up, get ready for brumation in just a handful of months. So she is done. She did really good. That mama was a good mama. Look at the size of this clutch right here for a second clutch. Ooh, doggy, that is amazing. 2, 4, 6, 8 good eggs. 8 good eggs on a second clutch is crazy when it comes to Puebla milk snakes. So unfortunately, that is the last egg box that I have set up. So I have to go ahead and set up some egg boxes in a second here. But I did notice when I was looking through this morning, you see right up here? What do you see? That's right, that's some more baby Kluber's. Now remember that kingsnake clutch hatched earlier in the year, but they always hatch really early. So the fact that these guys are out and these are corn snakes, this is a normal incubation time here. So let's just pop this lid really quick and see what we have here. Oh my gosh, some beautiful little snow corn snakes. How amazing. Let's just take a look at them and see what we got going on. And look at these cute little monkeys right here. Oh my gosh. Of course, this was actually a snow corn that was a possible head scaleless. It was bred to a snow scaleless corn snake. Unfortunately, I don't see any snow scaleless corn snakes in here, so she must not have been a het. So what these are is actually all snow corns that are het for scaleless corn snakes. But look at how absolutely adorable it is. Now that snow is actually a double recessive mutation. It's albino and anathristic, which means just obviously an albino and the anathristic are the black corn snakes. So basically these are lacking the black pigment and they're lacking the red pigment, leaving this kind of just beautiful pink color to them. And you can see some of their heads are still poking out, some bubbles over here where they're still coming out. So we still have 4 or 5 more eggs left to hatch. But I tell you what, guys, colubrid season is upon us. Once these guys start hatching, we're going to be hatching colubrid snakes almost every day for the next 2.5-3 months. That is super exciting because we have some insane clutches coming. Let's go ahead and check to see if we have anything here. Oh my gosh, look at, take a look at, guys. Unbelievable. A little Mexican blacking, a nigritus, his head is poking out right now. Oh my gosh. The first Mexican blackings are coming out too. These guys should be on the egg in the next day or two also. Oh my God. It's going to be an exciting couple months here at BHB. Unbelievable. I'm over the moon. Let's go ahead and set up a couple egg boxes so we can go ahead and pull these last couple clutches of colubrids. Getting some clutches. There's another Pueblan clutch, another second clutch. Doesn't look nearly as beat up as that last mom. Again, you know, I'm not terribly concerned about that first mom, but she definitely was beat up from production this year. So we'll see if this girl has a decent clutch or not. Looks like, oh yeah, it doesn't look too bad at all. Not as big as the first clutch, but still absolutely beautiful eggs. And again, this is a second clutch. So this girl, who looks really in good shape, is done for the year. She shouldn't take hardly any time to get kind of rebound and ready for brumation. And then she should be good to go for next year. She laid 2, 4, 6 good eggs for the second clutch. Not bad at all. I mean, so far the Pueblan year has been really good. We've got some new Pueblans that Lori showed you the other day that are coming up for next year that are even better, cleaner, wider bands, all that type of stuff. I think we have one corn snake clutch to collect still. This next clutch is actually from a hypo blood red that is actually het for plasma, which is the lavender diffused corns. And then this is actually just a double het lavender diffused corn or a plasma corn here. So we could get some plasma. She laid a really nice clutch the first clutch. So we'll see what she's got going on. Oops, she's got one egg over here. I don't know why she laid that out of the clutch box. We're gonna go ahead and check just to make sure there's no other eggs out anywhere else. It's a little weird. We'll get the shed out of here, get some water in here. You guys know the routine. And let's see what she's got going on. Okay. Well, she's definitely passed everything. Looks like there's only a couple eggs in here, which is really kind of weird, but she looks really good. I mean, looks like her conditioning is fantastic. It almost looks like she didn't even lay a clutch of eggs this year. She looks so good. So I wonder if there's only the 2 eggs in this box. I'm gonna go ahead and put them in here. I'll probably candle them just to make sure. I'm gonna check to see. Oh, there's a little slugger in the back over here. And then of course, this little egg that's pretty desiccated or dented in, we'll put it in here and hopefully we can save that egg. So it looks like we just had had three good eggs, one slug from that female, so that was absolutely a small clutch, but again, second clutches go that way. And that's it for collecting snake eggs for the day.
All right, guys, down here in the basement with our boy RJ, and we're down here for only one reason and one reason only, and that is to talk about our next challenge is coming up, all right? And by challenge, I mean 24-hour challenge or 3 a.m. challenge, all right? We're having a hard time deciding which one we should do, so we're gonna leave it up to you guys, right? We're either gonna do the 24-hour Lucy challenge, right? Or, are you ready for this, Eric? Or we're gonna do an overnight 3 a.m. challenge in RJ's car with RJ.
Dude, why don't we just do a 24-hour 3 a.m. challenge? Dude, think about it.
Mind blowing, man. But in RJ's pond, if we do that one, we're gonna be sitting there in pool floaties.
I'm honestly worried about that, dude.
Bro, we're gonna be in like those little, you know, those circular tubes that you're in the lazy river with, right?
Where what if he wakes up and wants a little midnight snack, a little inner tube?
That's why you gotta make sure that you got the Jack's Links beef jerky ready to just like, RJ, go get that over there.
I'm honestly nervous about this.
You should be. So make sure you guys like the comments down below. We're gonna have a couple comments down below saying either Lucy 24-hour challenge or RJ 3 a.m. challenge. Like those comments, and the one with the most likes is the challenge that we are going to do. So make sure you guys do that, and let us know your thoughts down below.
What we're doing today is we're going through baby colubrids. The other day, we marked a bunch of the larger ones that needed to move from middle-sized tubs up into adult-sized tubs, and Eric moved those up. So now what we're doing is we're moving the babies that are in shoe boxes that are now getting too big for these that go into the half tubs. So I've been going through, I've marked a few ones. We've got quite a few that he needs to move up. Some of them are pretty neat. I'm pretty excited about too.
Oh yeah, I like that one.
We've been working raising these gray bands up for a little while, so it's nice to see that these guys are definitely starting to get ready. Hopefully we'll have a few up next year. We'll definitely have the whole group up a year after. This is a really nice one.
I really like the color, look at it.
Yeah, this is Blair's phase, and I've always been a fan of those. Another one I can show you guys is, again, I was showing you yesterday, we've got a Cal King group that's growing up. Here's a really nice albino Cal King. Again, getting too big for the shoe boxes, ready for that middle-sized tub. So she can definitely probably, if she eats really good for you, she'll be ready to breed next year.
That's awesome.
And one more, because these are always near and dear to my heart, raising up a few new hognose. Because you can never have enough of these. People love them, and this is a nice chunky female.
Every time.
I mean, these things are just like garbage disposals,
yeah,
aren't they?
Seriously. No, they bite fingers. Me every time. Every single time. I think it's that one up there because I reach up and it gets me on surprise.
But
and
it doesn't bite me, see? Just Eric.
Because I smell like frogs, probably.
Exactly. But anyways, I just put these orange tags on, so there's quite a few up here. So Eric, you got your work cut out for you.
Job security.
Remember the other day I cut that black pastel lesser to an Enchi Pin banana clutch? Oh my God, they came out of the eggs and they are ridiculous. You guys ready for this? There they are. Unbelievable. Remember I said I wasn't even sure what this animal is right here? I was like, what is that? I thought it might be like a calico. Well, now it makes a whole lot of sense now that it climbed out. And that's what happens. Oftentimes in the egg, you're guessing, but you can't see the animal. Once it climbs out, you have a complete understanding of what's going on. This, of course, is a black pastel Enchi. And those two together just make those unbelievably oranges come through. Oh my God, I was excited. And that's kind of like the least as far as two gene animals in the clutch, other than this one here, which is a banana Enchi ball python. Now the banana and the Enchi mix really well together. Again, tons of oranges come through, reduction of pattern, really cool blushing. I mean, this is an absolutely beautiful animal. And then moving on to the next animal that is actually a black pastel lesser banana. So it's a three gene animal, and that black pastel and lesser mix together really good, much like the Cine and lesser do as well. And then you put it into the banana and it just makes a really interesting animal. I love the color hues and the tones. I mean, this is a really beautiful snake, but the creme de la creme, the one that just blew me away, was all five genes in one. That's right, we basically have a banana, Enchi, black pastel, kingpin. Of course, the kingpin is the pinstripe and the lesser. So we have all five genes. We have banana, we have Enchi, we have black pastel, we have pinstripe, and we have lesser. And oh my gosh, is that thing a ripper! pepper. I mean, it's absolutely gorgeous. I tell you what, this is a powerhouse. And by the way, I think I'm gonna be keeping this guy because I just love him. I cannot wait till he grows up, gets a little bit more coloration in him as that banana starts to turn. It's gonna get even more incredible. And down the road, this is gonna be a great animal to breed to a bunch of females. So again, I thought this was a decent clutch when we cut it, but once everything climbed out of the egg, I was blown away at how amazing these animals are. So that's one clutch. And I also have a pastel to a pastel scaleless head that all hatched out as well. And let's see what we have in this clutch. Now again, it's really hard to tell if it's a scaleless head in the egg because their heads are typically buried. Not to mention, a lot of scaleless heads aren't lacking a lot of scales on their head. They're just kind of jumbled patterns and stuff like that. So until you get them out and really take a close look at them, you can't really tell. This one is just a normal ball python, not scaleless or anything. The interesting thing about this clutch is it was a pastel bred to a pastel scaleless head, and we didn't get any super pastels, just a couple pastels. But nevertheless, this is absolutely a pastel scaleless head. You can see it's missing a bunch of scales on its head. So that's one pastel scaleless head for sure. Let's take a look at this little normal. Oh yeah, right off the bat, you can tell this animal is lacking scales on its head. So we've got one pastel scaleless head. We've got one scaleless head. We'll look at this other normal right here and see. Oh, and this is a great example. It's just a little bit of missing scales, but this is definitely a scaleless head normal. But there's not a lot of scales missing, but there's 100% no doubt about it. Usually right down where that V kind of matches, that's where it usually is lacking, kind of almost like the brow between the eyes. That one's definitely a scaleless head as well. And then lastly, a pastel scaleless head for sure. So that actually was a really good clutch. We didn't get the super pastel, but we got two pastel scaleless heads, we got two scaleless head, and just one normal. So not bad, huh? So anyways, I just wanted to update you on the animals we cut the other day. So I have actually three tours back to back to back to back, so it's going to be a busy few hours, but it's going to be absolutely amazing. I think my first tour is here now.
Hey guys, welcome guys. Where did you say you were from again?
We're actually from Independence, Missouri.
Independence, Missouri. Perfect timing for the 4th of July, right? So that's great. Love your shirt and your Charmander. So what do you say we look at a bunch of cool animals?
Let's do it.
All right, my next tour is in the house. Where are you guys from?
Wyoming.
Wyoming.
We came all the way here just to see this.
Get out of here. Yeah. Oh my gosh. Well, I'll do the best I can do to hang out and make sure it's worth it.
Absolutely.
You ready? All right, let's do this. All right, so the deal is that I was the number one choice here.
Yeah.
They chose the Brian tour over the Noah and Eric tour.
That's messed up.
But they did
I got a lot of feelings.
What you said, if I wasn't available,
it would have been Eric.
Yeah, because this is when we had to come. So.
Oh, second best, huh?
Second best.
First to worst, second to best.
I fangirled enough when Lori just called.
Say hi to your dad.
Hey dad, how's it going, man? Hope you feel better.
I hope his dad feels better. I hope that you can come out next time and come visit with me too. So I'll be sending positive vibes your way. In the meantime, let's look at this panel.
All right, let's do it.
And I think I'm gonna go ahead and end the day here. Wish you guys an amazing day. Tell you how much I love your beautiful faces. Ask you to be kind to someone. And I promise I will see you guys tomorrow.